it's not far down to paradise. At least it's not for me. And if the wind is right, you can sail away, find tranquility. Oh, the canvas can do miracles. Just you wait and see. Believe me, it's not far to Never Never Land. No reason to pretend. And if the wind is right, you can find the joy of innocence again. Oh, the canvas can do miracles. Just you wait and see. It's the best of me when I'm sailing. All caught up in the reverie. Every word is a symphony. Won't you believe me? Sailing takes me away.
Shell, Chevron, and Mobil are going to be the main ones.
Exxon is like the biggest oil company.
Mom, look at the camera.
Oh. Hello, camera.
Okay. Yes, we're in a limousine.
Get your own back.
Who's got an elevator?
We don't have one of those in there.
I was trying to get out of this.
You're stinking.
They stink.
Where? David, we'll get there in a little while. We're going that way.
That way?
Yeah. We gotta go back that way when we go to the ship.
Thanks for waiting for me.
Girls, for sure. Come here, let me tell you a little secret.
Come here, pretty girl.
You see him?
No, when I come over here, I see him.
Don Maria? This is what we refer to as the hallway from hell.
Okay, well, let's get everybody
down. Sit down.
Josh, come sit down.
Let's
go over there. Here. Here.
You're not going to eat them.
Up there for 3 hours. running about 3 football fields long. Suitcase were on the floor. Now that's service.
Like I said, they were clean when I came in.
They look like this?
After Steven. Yeah, they look like this, and I was like 10
minutes
after.
We need to get room service like this at home.
Oh,
yeah, right.
Oh, hint. All right. What'd you guys get for Barbara? Oh,
wasn't
that?
Listen to that, Mom. You should clean my room like they cleaned this room.
I ate all the jelly beans.
There was clothes all over.
Is that why I saw jelly beans out on the carpet?
You saw them?
Yes.
You were throwing them.
Here, this is your thing for the day.
Oh, tell me if there's a single day sign, please.
Oh my God, what's in 944?
Are you taking your vitamins?
This is mine.
I'm
going to
take them today.
Where's mine?
What?
This is mine. All right.
You know, we need to check with him and see if our thing's going to be back by tonight. Let's see.
Take it in, Rita.
Huh?
Can't have it.
Can't get in?
No. And here's the hangout for the kids. Stripes.
This is it.
Favorite place.
Hangout.
Over by the door.
Are you dead right now?
Too early. This place will be jumping in a half an hour.
Thank you.
up.
We are going up.
We're not moving.
Yeah, we're getting off here. Promenade. But we were just up there. We're going up one more.
Married couples up here, and they're going to tell us all about their marriage. Now, a lot of you have asked, can I come up here and take part? Well, we're going to try and get three different couples representing three very different stages of married life. Now, first of all, I'm looking for a honeymoon couple. Let's see how many honeymoon couples. Lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of you. Right, I think the fairest way to do this is try and find a younger honeymoon couple. I think, anybody married at 18?
Yeah.
18? Where?
Right here.
You're 18?
Yeah.
You're just drunk. Oh, okay, that's fair. Well, if you're drunk, that's obviously qualified. Are you on your honeymoon?
Yeah.
Are you enjoying your honeymoon?
Yeah.
Is that your wife next to you? Because she's looking at you like she's pissed off at you, sir. All right, they're going to come and help me. All right, you volunteer. Give them a nice round of applause. He's dragging them. I said, wait for your wife, sir, you're supposed to be married. I said, hold her hand, look nice. Hold her hand, sir. Well, pull her, that's good enough, yeah. There you go, sir. He is thick, yeah. Come over here, guys. We'll have the young lady sit here, and you can sit here, sir, for me. I said, you sit here, sir. Sir, that refers to the man. Good. Okay, hi.
Hi.
You really don't want to be here, do you?
Okay.
That's the end of your honeymoon right there. You'll be hanging out with the boys for the rest of the week. She's pissed at you. What's your name, love?
Lashawn,
where are you from?
Maryland.
There you go. That's right. How long have you been married? He does all the talking, doesn't he? Yes. What week? And how's he doing so far? And who's the boss?
We are.
We are. Hi, sir. Hi, what's your name?
Greg.
Greg, she says we are the boss, is that right?
Yes.
You're not in charge?
Sometimes.
Does it, you've been married a week, does it feel like a week?
Yeah.
It does. Alright, well, we have a certain rule here, and that is you can't talk to each other until after the game, so turn around and give each other a nice kiss goodbye here. And she's over there. And she's over here, that's it, give her a kiss. Ah, that's nice. Give them a nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, there's a pencil for you, and a very little one for you, sir. Couple number two, I'm looking for someone who'd been married middle of the road distance, somewhere like 20-something years. First man or woman standing married 20-something years. Stand up if you want to take part, don't shout it because I can't pick anybody out that way. Man or woman standing, as a woman, I don't have a man or a woman, I got one of each. That, are you standing so you're sort of hovering there? How long have you been married? 22 years, you'll be fine. Give them a nice hand. So you have a seat there, have the lady sit there. Or you can sit on his knee, which you prefer, yeah. There we go. Hi, what's your name?
Rita.
Rita, where are you from?
Florida.
Florida. How long have you been married, Rita?
22 years.
And who's the boss?
I am, of course.
And you? Rita's the boss? Hi. What's your name, sir?
Frank.
Frank. She's Rita's the boss, is that right?
Sometimes.
Sometimes. You know what you're told. sometimes. You've been married 22 years. It doesn't feel like that?
Definitely.
A happy couple here. Turn around and give each other a kiss. Ooh, that's nice. Give them a nice round of applause. Happy number two. That's for you. That's for you. Right, let's look for an older married couple here. Do I have anybody married a long time? Anybody managed 40 or more years? They're looking for our oldest married couple. Let's see. Anybody married a long time? How many years there? 40. Anybody been 40? 40 going once? 40 going twice? 40. Would you like to help me out? He's coming up. Let's just stay there. All right, give them a nice hand, folks. They're coming up here after 40 years together. That's not a marriage. That's a long time, yeah. It's an institution, yes. That's right. How are you doing, darling? Nice to see you. Come and have a seat here. And sir, you have a seat right there. Thanks for dressing up for this, sir. Appreciate that. That's nice. Hi. What's your name?
Faye.
Faye, where are you from?
New Orleans.
New Orleans. 40 years. Now, we asked this at the grandparents and honeymooners party, purely from a lady's point of view, what is your secret to all the young honeymoon ladies to being able to stay married to one man for 40 years? What's your secret?
Let's see. Just give and take, you know? Try to,
What was that?
She gives and I take.
Okay. That's your secret, is it, sir?
Yes.
Yes. What's your name?
Bill.
Bill. Hi, Bill. What's your secret then to the guys? What else do you have to say to all the young honeymoon men?
Fight all day, love all night.
20 kids or something like that, do you? Seven children, my God. Seven.
Seven children gave us this cruise.
Are there any more children now after this cruise? Are you two still producing? Or? Oh, I see. You got that smile. You're drooling at the side of your mouth there, sir. Just thinking about it.
Maybe if you're 60 years old, then you can still, you know, might become real popular.
Men would be interested in you. Yeah, yeah. Anyway, turn around and give her a kiss for me. That's it, she's over there. Ladies and gentlemen, these three married couples are about to entertain you. Let's give them all a very big round of applause. Right, let's explain the game right now. This, of course, is a newlywed and not newlywed game. I will be asking you all 10 questions. Every time I ask a question, I want you both to write down the answer, so at the end you will have completed 10 different questions. What we're trying to get you to do, without cheating, talking, or conferring, is try and write down the same thing. We're trying to get you to write down the same answer and find out how much you really know. Just pull those packages out. They're there somewhere, darling. You're fine. Oh, your pencil. Yeah, there's yours, yeah. I put one on your chair. You must be sitting on it, sir. Where did it go? Oh, I've got a spare one. There we are. There's probably no feeling down there anymore anyway, so. So at the end of the contest, you have completed 10 different questions. And what we're trying to get you to do, as I said, is write down the same thing. Now, the questions will start off nice and simple. The further down the list, we'll get a little bit more cheeky. Is that okay? Good. Now, again, remember, tell the truth and try and write down your answers as full as you possibly can. We'll start off with a nice simple one. And of course, if you're sitting next to your husband or your wife, please put them in the audience so that you can answer these along with you. Right, while they finish up, does anybody have any unusual places they'd like to share with us? A bit of audience participation. Yes, ma'am. Saudi Arabia. Just all over Saudi Arabia. Have your own Scud missile, did you? Yes, sir. On a tractor. Who said on a Lido? On a Lido deck? That was you banging it against my window, was it? Oh! This is definitely the kinky side. These are all normal people over here. Anybody else want to say anything? Yes, yes, ma'am. On the monorail going to Disney World. Just picture Mickey chasing after you with hot dogs. M-C-K-Y-O-U-S-O-B. Right. We're going to read out these answers right now, and if you get a question right, please put a match or a cross or something next to it so we can count up at the end. We got right on a monorail going to Disney. Here's question number one. Where am I going to first meet? You say you met at Tacoma Park on a subway bus station in May 1991. He walked wearing yellow sweatpants. He picked me up in front of a 7-Eleven. You say you met at a subway stop. She looked good. She was wearing blue and was outside of a 7-Eleven in 1991. That's very good. So she was standing outside of that 7-Eleven and he showed up. What did you think when you first saw him? Was it love at first sight?
No.
What do you think when he approached you? Good, good, good. And what did you think when you first saw her?
I liked her, but I was kind of like sweating. I was cleaning the house when I walked her up.
You just walked over there and invited her out?
I drove from my house with my buddy and went to see her. It was like a first time meeting.
Was it love at first sight for you?
It was good look at first time.
Lust at first sight, yes. I see. How long did you date before you were married? How long?
A year.
A year and a half. And as you got better as time progressed, you're in love. You're in love. You say you met, let's see, you say at my cousin's wedding on April the 11th, 1970. He was in the wedding, he was wearing a lovely tuxedo, he looked fabulous, he had tight pants on that showed off his lovely butt. You say you met in April 1977, her cousin's wedding. She had on a tight white dress and looked awesome. That's a nice dress. So you hope you're wearing tight things. And when you saw her, did you think, God, look at that, this is the one for me?
Yeah, it's her dress.
I saw them as well when she leaned forward earlier. I'm sorry. Oh, you say, I didn't read that, but he had a head, a beautiful young head of hair. Nothing changed, huh? You don't have any hair, but she still has the breasts. I saw that. You say you first met at the Circle Movie Theatre in 1949. He was lovely, he looked great, and he looked very handsome. And you say you met at the movie theatre. In 1945, she was wearing a tight mini skirt. How about that? There's a match. Very good. What year did you say? 49, yeah.
No match.
Well, it's a few years out. It's a few years out. You met a lot of girls at that movie theatre, didn't you, Harry? There you go. Do you remember what movie you went to see?
Oh, no.
When did he put his arm around you in the movie theater?
No, he didn't. You know, I liked him off, you know, right when I saw him, but he didn't like me.
Oh, why not?
Like a cousin.
Oh, you liked a cousin? Oh, I see. You liked the cousin. Kept it in the family. What was the name of your last girlfriend? Describe a few words about her. You say her name was Deirdre, and she was a little possessive and a nymphomaniac. You say her name was Deirdre, she was an ignorant fat pig, and a complete bitch from hell. She was a fat pig, ignorant and a bitch. Do you ever see Deirdre anymore?
She has a son.
Oh, do you say you still see her every now and then? So we better not send her a copy of the video, huh? Just point to Deirdre. Hi, Deirdre, we love you. No, I can't say it. No. You say her name was Joey. Is that right, Joey? Joey, she looked like a grandmother and had hair growing out of her nose. Her name was Deb. What did you say her name was? Joey. Well, who's Debbie Rose then?
Loving poor Joey.
Did you forget about Joey?
Yeah, I guess I do.
You say her name was Debbie Rose. She was short and nice and had the biggest breasts you've ever seen. Definitely got a thing about breasts, you, haven't you? Seen one, you've seen them both. You say her name was, what is that?
Inel.
She was a beautiful redhead and my cousin. What's the cousin? You say her name was Inel. She was a redhead and she was a cousin to my wife. There's another match for you. Very good. So what changed your mind from her to, from your cousin to your wife?
A swimming picnic.
What happened at the swimming
pool? At the bar
then. The picnic?
At the picnic.
Why? Did she just, all of a sudden, you realise you were with the wrong woman?
2 years later, right.
You still with the cousin?
Oh, yes.
What happened to her?
Went to the picnic with her.
And you left with your wife?
Correct.
You're a right goer, aren't you? Yes. Never seen ugly until you see my wife's blank. You think you'll put your feet? What's wrong with them? You think you haven't seen ugly to see my wife's family? This man is scared. You're officially cut off from now. That's it. We won't ask for it to family, never mind. You say you think you put your pot belly and you put her feet. What's wrong with her feet?
Oh,
God. Oh, they are. Those two, they're like claws, those two toes. What bent over? You could swoop over a river and pick a fish up with those two toes. He'll put your stomach, and he put, I'll let you read this one, her ass. I've got a breast man and a bottom man right here, just oh, well done guys, you haven't seen ugly, see my wife's blank, you think she will put you when you make faces. What kind of faces?
Just normal faces. Move my lip up and down or something.
Move your lip up and down.
It's kind of different.
You think it's his ugly feet and toes? What's wrong with his feet?
Keep them covered, sir.
You think she'll put your eyes when I roll them back? What's that? Show the audience. Go on, you can show the audience. You want to see him? There he is. Stand up for my performance. Here we go. You put his hairy toes. It's the feet family. You think it's going to be your... I'll just read it as this. You think your ugliest thing is your shriveled ding-dong. Anyway, and you put his tiny peck. Big Bill, it's not Big Bill, it's Wee William, isn't it? That's right. It's not making this PG-17 this show, my God. Oh dear, what's your wife's most annoying habit? You think your most annoying habit is that you call him child all the time. Child, in a sentence.
Child, please.
Child, please. Oh, anything. And you put, being quiet when I ask her a question. She's quiet. Yeah, and that gets on your nerves. Are you going to change? You think your most annoying habit is talking all the time. And you put, she talks during everything. Always, always talking. There's a good match there. You think that your most annoying habit is you are disorganized. And you put, she is not organized. There's a good match. In what way is she not organized? Anyway.
I have to organize everything. The freezers, the food cabinets, the luggage when we go someplace, everything.
Is that true?
All the time.
It happened all the time, yeah. You and me, Willie, over here. Okay. Question number six. What is your husband's most annoying habit? You think your most annoying habit is asking her about her attitude. Explain that one.
She thinks I asked her about her attitude. I inquire about something because I feel I need to ask her.
Good answer. And you think picking his nose and flicking the boogers at me. The people you share in your cabin next week, they've got new patches coming and they're getting really excited. They walk into the cabin, there's going to be boogers all over the mirror. Lovely. You think your most annoying habit is clearing your throat? How do you do that? But from the wrong end. When he gets excited about something, he farts. Don't get him excited, please. Just calm down. Put you two in the same cabin, we only have to sanitize one then. You think your most annoying habit is that you always sleep when she wants to do something else? Winkle, yes. You think it's puts his teeth together in front and growls? You have to show the audience what she means there. You'll stand up and show them. Yeah. Here we have another performance here. Extra stretch limousine with a booger on the end, yeah. And you think you are a Ford dump truck. Close. You think he's a stretch limousine, you think you are a Ford dump truck with a very bad exhaust system. And you think he's a pink Volkswagen with two flat tires, and you absolutely agree with her. You think you're a Volkswagen as well. What movie title best describes your marriage? You have put Love Story, and you have put Love Story as well. Yours has to be Gone with the Wind, isn't it? And so did you. Love Story, right there, yes. You put Gone with the Wind. And you put Gone with the Wind as well. Yes. What time of their night does your husband get that amorous feeling? And you put Anytime, All the Time. And you put All Day, All Night, The Thing Won't Go Down. Thank you. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, we have a honeymoon couple. And if you ever go to Megan's Bay, well, we'll make sure the water's clean before you get in there. Ladies and gentlemen, this young man and this young woman, we wish them the best in their marriage together. Don't we? Give them a big round of applause. Thank you very much. Best of luck to you. Say hi to your ex-wife for me. We'll send the video. Couple number two, ladies and gentlemen, 22 years married. A lot of fun. I'm giving you more bubbles as well, really, is it? Really? Where are you sitting? Over there? He's coming back. Everybody move back a few rows. Go over those windows. Give them both a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, number two. Thank you, guys. Have a seat.
Thank you.
Hey guys, look here. Maria. Tony, put that down. About 10 minutes ago, and we're walking through the streets looking at stuff, and the kids saw all these pigeons and decided they, especially Tony, decided she wanted to try and feed them. This guy would get his big butt out of the way, be able to get a better picture. A double butt. Safe there for kids?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
We just want to take care
tonight,
of her.
Yeah,
I'm not safe. A kid. She's almost a kid.
She's not a kid, Frank. You gotta get a shotgun pretty soon.
That's true.
No, don't be getting all happy. So,
But you can go out and not drink.
That's
and
true.
I have my donkey if you don't have.
In La Plaza. Like a different open place where all different of you are going.
You didn't get the baby.
Right, I forgot.
Yeah.
And if you have brown stool, they have a local policeman there.
Be glad for that.
Huh? We're in St. Thomas. And I'm up on the top deck. And this is the view from the deck. If you go on the shore in about an hour, we're going to go snorkeling today. It's really a nice place here. These green mountains. Inside the ship now, this is what you see from the dock. These are all taxis waiting to take people somewhere. These guys are like vultures when you get off the ship. Thank you.
Had it.
I like him, Maria.
Your car gets it all the way.
Where all this traffic coming from, man? This is unusual traffic. Somebody walking.
Where's my camera?
Too much.
Too much?
$1.60. It takes me about $30.
It's the last island. Gotta go to Miami next. This was a fun place to be. Exceptionally beautiful tonight.
But what was wrong with the other night?
I don't know.
Maybe your eyes were clean today by this
little water. Go ahead, show them your
Maybe I just had more to drink today.
show the camera your ring.
Okay, I want to show my bracelet.
I want to show my bracelet too.
And I got nothing. Did anybody buy me a t-shirt?
I did.
You didn't have enough money.
I got you a t-shirt.